All right, someone. I've finished doing all of the outside and it's and sealed it and placed a couple of major vis portals. By major, as in, I mean obvious places where I should put them. I have gone in game, but I forgot to check if they're working. Let me hide the clips and the node drawer, the vis portals for now. You can see various bits that I've grabbed from the new job map. This obviously used to be pointing left. I've obviously spun it around, so it's pointing down, and gone and tweaked a few things. Obviously, that's in the old map. That's where the player would come through. I've blocked that off because it's just window dressing at the moment. This is where the player is going to start now, or I've set it to start now, I should say. If you come up with a better idea, or if you want me to build some another location, like say a small sewer section that I've used in Elixir, I'm happy to do that. What else? Something else you've noticed there. You probably wondered why I've put those over the top. Basically, the player and AI. I don't know if you've seen it in videos where AI jumps up and down like they're stumbling over something or tripping over something. That's basically things like this. Even though the AI can walk over this, it's a pain in the ass. It's easier to make the thing non-solid and then just place a no-draw solid brush of your appropriate texture around roughly this the thing. What this also does is a sort of bit of a cheat. If you find it's too narrow between the edge of that and that pillar, making that non-solid and then just pressing the brush there, it's a bit of a cheat. It allows the player to walk through, and AI for that matter. So that's a monster clip. What else do I need to show you? So one city gate there, some city lights. I've already had a quick look in the map and the lighting's pretty good already, but when I need to tweak it a little bit. Put this, I don't know what you call it. There's a name for what that is. You know, you build a building that's an archway and a bridge between two. That can't go anywhere, unfortunately, because it basically that room into the tavern is, as you can see, flipping stairwell. It's a shame that it's that part of the building, but hey, what are you going to do? So basically, what this could be is a storeroom, like you've seen, or like we've all seen in Dishonored 2 and Dishonored 1. You know, like there's like a room. It's almost like a storage room, stroke tool room, stroke something room. But basically, the idea was to give this part of the map a little bit of flavor, a bit of difference, and it allows me to put a vis portal underneath this area here, completely sealing off this part of the map from that part of the map. And because the vis portal is small, the show triz or the triz amount or the primitives, the draw course through it will be nice and small. There, like you can see how far down the cork brush goes straight through. If I hide all the entities, there you go. So there's a vis portal underneath there, and as you can see, I've done the same thing over the top through the roofs with cork. Now you're probably wondering why I've sliced straight through entities with cork, or I should say funk statics with cork. Models, I don't know how many people know this, probably lots of people do, or you might even know about it, but they render through cork. As long as you can see part of the model from one side like there, even though the whole most of the model is on the other side, it'll be as if the whole model, you can see the whole model. The only thing you won't see from this side is that, but you will see it from this side, but a small price to pay. I mean, if I could be extra tweaky about it and get that viewable, etc., etc., but to be honest, in this stage in the game for this map, it's not worth that much effort. I spent a lot of time doing the outside as it is. What else? Oh, I was right about that flipping skin. So this, I'm gonna have to create a bug tracker for this, but that's got lit windows for that specific mixed blocks texture, but it's not lit, so the skin is broken. So I have to fix that, and I'm going to make a bug tracker. So I don't know whether that'll get included with 206, but failing that, it'll go with 207. What else? change the texture of the courtyard here. I think you've seen this already. I might even drop the scale of that. I'll have a look in game. I think I showed you this already. This is the gateway to the beer garden. Created some extra flavour along here, some details. Put a door there. That brush there is the clone that I made for Elixir. I made the same as that brush there, and I just copied it over so I could move this door over there right into the corner to give boats passing through here a reasonable gap. I know it doesn't have to be totally realistic, but that's the way I like to build maps. My view is you build them so they look like they would in real life or as close as possible, and it gives it lends more to the realism. I think you've seen all this stuff already. Ah, so there you go. So let me hide all the entities in there. You can see if I go up, you can see all the ceiling sides of the map now. So basically all the outside. It's a bit higgledy-piggledy, but I've picked up that higgledy-piggledy from Milan and a few other mappers that I've worked with, that you don't have to be hyper tidy with everything, although certain things bug me and I want to make them hyper tidy. Like, what's this? Yeah, that does need to go back there. Ground. That patch there, I picked up on the fact that Spring made that one curved, and I think on new job, don't quote me, but there was a decal brush there, so I've done the same thing. And it makes that whole thing a bit darker. I don't know what it does to DC, but I don't think you could do that without a decal patch. You'd have to create a custom texture, etc., or a blended texture. I'm trying to remember if I did anything for the inside between the last time you saw. I don't think I have. I think I did basically all the work I've been doing is on the outside. Yeah. All right. Oh yes. clip textures. I've been going around the map slowly adding clip texture. Now, the golden rule is you always extend. That's a bad example, but monster clip all the way to the ceiling, so that way you don't get the map trying to pathfind. Basically, if this thing was down here, for example, the engine would try and create pathfind code over the top of that. You don't want that, so it just makes for faster demapping and cleaner pathfinding. Another little top tip, you can see that cart in there. What I've done is I obviously created the original monster clip brush, then I clipped it just above the top of the cart. Let me ungroup that so you can see what I'm doing. Ungroup, motherfucker. Thank you. I've put a bit of texture to match this because I've made the whole cart, including all the things. In fact, I didn't make those non-solid. Now I'm going to make them non-solid. There we go. The reason for doing that is it makes climbing over it a lot easier. Let's trim this brush. There we go. And another little top tip, if I do there, you've got caulk on either side of the slice. So what you can do is you can select a texture and then just do that, and it basically applies it to both surfaces that you've just got caulk on. And then I'm going to place wood underneath that one there. So when the player walks over it, they get wood bits, and you get carpety bits for... I don't know the way that's sliced though, so let's put this down. Yeah, that's not gonna work, is it? I should have sliced that different. Yeah, slice it this way. Make it carpet, make the bottom wood, and then move the textures up this way. There we go. So where was I? Back to here. Wood that you'll climb over as the player, but then the rest of it will be carpet. In fact, if I'm going to be anal about this, let's do that so that you, the player, only gets carpet texture when walking above the package. I can extend this no draw brush all the way to the floor. Right, here we go. Made things like that non-solid. In fact, let's move them. Flipping DR's gone all skew if. So that player and AI don't do the hopscotch above it or hop skip. Same thing goes for all these curbstones, they're all non-solid. Because basically you've just got a little bit there of the actual pavement, and then I've obviously placed the curbstones around it. There isn't much of a jump. In fact, do these sink? No. So the only bit that's lower than that is the road itself. It's wide enough for carts and horse carts and whatnot. That one there is probably wide enough for the horse-drawn carriage. Right, back to monster clipping. Always extends to the roof or to the ceiling. And what I've been doing is going around, finding stuff that I need to draw around. Like, say, for example, all this clutter. It's got the wrong texture on it, so middle mouse click on any brush with the texture you want and it takes you straight to it. So watch this, let's try another example. If I middle click there, takes me to caulk. Middle click on the draw on the monster brush, happy days. I'm basically monster clipping all the way around the map where I know AI may potentially go or run into, because if you don't do this, what you get is what's known as treadmilling, where they're just going in circles. Oh no, they do treadmilling and going in circles. Yeah, and you don't want AI doing that. So I've just been going around. I think I'm going to hand the map to you at this point and start getting you into the habit of monster clipping the right way, because a lot of your old map was missing all of that. There wasn't an adequate amount of monster clipping. Oh, floater. No, don't want to do that. Clipping against them all. No, there we go. Nice. I'm going to run this over and cover that bit of broken pallet. Jubbly. So a player, the AI should be able to pass fine through there. What did I cover there? Oh, I don't. Idiot. I don't need to do that. Oh, that's why I covered there, because of those steps. Yeah, I don't know if the AI will pass through in that. Probably not. So what I might do is put some clutter just there. We'll see. I'll have a look in the map. Right, let's go around this lamp. More clutter over there. Oh, another top tip. You want to create a node draw, create a brush the same size or same height as another brush, just click on one at the height you require, in this case, the monster clip brush. I've just got to verify where. Oh, there we go. It's just there. So I've got the brush selected, deselect. The new brush I'll draw will be the same height as the one you had selected. Happy days. Got a bucket there to cover. There we go. I need to ungroup that because I can't see anything when I'm selecting just a singular item. Make that non-solid, I think. Yeah. So like I say, I've been slowly going around the map doing this. It's going to take a lot of monster clipping because of all the outside brushes. So all the outside models. What you could do is dual do the inside and the outside like that. Obviously don't block off the main doorway. Oh no, I've gone too far because now I'm going into the edge of the stairs, which you don't want to do. Let's find the inside of the brush in there. Sorry, inside of the model, I should say, the module. There we go. Very nice. To cover basically this, what the hell do you call that? Base stone. And then clone that. I don't need to draw a new one. And then run that down the outside of the edge of the building, all the way up to the front door. Another curbstone, clone that across. So you see, you get my point. Basically what needs to be done, there's a lot of monster clipping needs to be done. You have to do this on map. I know it's laborious, and it's normally, for me, it's the last thing I do on when building a map, because you know where you've got most of your placement, etc. I don't know why I did that. I should have just created one brush. Let's match those. Grand. I think that's taking out a smidge more. Oh, that's floating. Naughty. Come on, stop being a shit. Then, that's better, sort of. Right, same thing goes for all the other buildings. Like I say, I've done a massive chunk of that side of the map already, so what I'm going to do is hand it over to you and get you to do the other side. What I'll do is I'll drop you a PM as opposed to waiting for you to see the video. I suppose it's one of the benefits of having a square, very square looking building. Or squarish, or very squarish? That's the wrong word. As in, it nothing at weird angles. It makes makes monster clipping so much easier. Oh yeah, I've got to fill in that flipping gap, haven't I? Another top tip. Fill up the map with monster clip, or if you don't monster clip, seal off. Think of it as like sealing, Visport ceiling. It's not the same, but basically It's just the good practice. It basically stops the engine trying to pathfind or creating pathfind code where there's no need to. That whole back area there is going to be nice and easier to do because the AI is never going to get in there. Yeah, let me do the fence bit just there now. What we put there? Some of this. Perfect. What I could do is probably make this a bit narrower so it looks like an actual fence. Let's call it 0.9, 0.85. Nope, that was the thinness. Don't want to do that. So it's got to be that one. Nope, that was the height. So it's the end one. So where's the first one? There's the first one, there's the second one, there's the third one. There we go. Alright, 6.5 I think. Right, 0.7 then. Grand. And let's spin that round. Happy days. Is that lined up nicely with that one? It is now. Just enough to poke through. There we go. That's that little alleyway blocked off. And then we'll do the, there's the clip just there. Grand. Right, what are we up to? 23 minutes. So let's see how much more I can monster the clip in 7 minutes and keep this video under an hour, under half an hour. Nice. That's what we like. I'll have to do some trimming there, I think. Sweet. Gonna do the same thing with this cart as I did with the other one. Oh, I'm an idiot. This cart isn't tilted like the other one. Come on. And make all this solid zero. In fact, I don't know why more mappers don't do this, because it makes, like I say, getting around that much easier. You don't keep tripping over things. Right, this looks like all of this part of the map is done. What we got left? 3 minutes. Okie dokie. Let's do that. Don't know what you call this thing. A market stall. I want to take this all the way down here, aren't I? Yes, indeed. And then a little bit extra for there. Do is we'll take these all the way in there and put a little bit in there for that gate, and then this can just go straight down here. I don't have to be neat and tidy about it. Where's that curbstone? There it is. Sorry, base stone. And this place has a little bit of monster clip on the inside as well. Happy days. Nice. Right, let's do the top bit across there. fact, what am I doing? Don't need to go across there, do I? I just need to do the, yeah, these bits. Grand. Let's do this bit here next to this curbstone. Sorry, base stone, I keep calling them curbstones. Right, well, that's the outside done then. I've basically monster clipped that whole canal area so the AI can't get in there. I think that's it. Hang on. That curbstone there needs looking at. Base stone, curbstone. Right, done and dusted. Oh, need to make some brushes around here. Yeah, AI and the player stumble over patches, so it's easier just to make them non-solid, I should say, and place no draw brush around there instead, like I've done there. Grand. That gate will be open, be pickable. But at the moment, it's not bloody functioning properly. So that's going to require some tweaking. Grand. Oh, I need to run a brush. Oops. That one, no, that one there. We'll clone that one. Nice. That'll just be a case of monster clipping the inside. So let me hide the first floor, the basement, and the ground floor, and the roof. Oh, let's move some stuff to the roof. There. I know him needs to go on the ground floor. Outside. Well, that's all the monster clip brush. Nice. Let's check fizz portals. No, they've moved as well. Yeah, happy days. I hide the collision filter because it allows me to see the models properly. Right, basement. That is an outside brush. So that's where they're going. In fact, all of that is outside. Why am I seeing this? Grand. So basically all you need, we need to do now is place no clip throughout all the models. So I think you get a general idea of the way I've been no clipping things. Obviously we have to make gaps for the doorways. So what you could do, if you wanted to cheat a little on for speed, is clone the ceiling brushes that I've done and retexture them. Blam! Instant no draw, and sorry, instant monster brush, and then just drag it through and it gives you your brush on both sides. And then we could do cheat and then do this. What I'll do is I'll do the basement and then I can get you to do the ground floor and the first floor. Nice. Just grab a handful of that. Oh, that's why I trimmed it. Basically, as I'm going along, I'm creating the gaps for the doorways. In fact, we don't probably don't want the AI going down into the boiler area at all. Grand. Now I've created a bunch of around the to make AI and the player crawl up, get up and down the stairs easier. I've made the whole stairs non-solid and then just placed no draw solid wood around. I think that's the basement mostly done. Ah, the beds in the barracks. And the pillars. And then do the footlockers. And then the bed and the footlocker on the end. Grand. Oh, still there. Oh, so all that's left is the toilet. Right, jobbed. Right, so there's the basement. So there's a quick how to monster clip, speed monster clip. Right, so I'll save the map and I'll drop you a PM with it and get you to monster clip the other two floors, and then we can start working on optimizing the map, pulling the stuff out of your old map into this map. Alright, let me save this vid, upload the map, finished map, or the map in its current status to Mega, and then put a link in the forum. Right, speak to you in a bit.